is a follow-up video based on the comparison video we created, where I compared different types of task management tools. So this video is about SharePoint tasks. We'll see how to create them, how to create subtasks, how to link them, how to draw a Gantt chart, and more. Go to Office 365, go to All Apps, choose SharePoint, and say create a site. We'll create a team site. We'll create a standard team site. So give it a name, give it a description, and that's it. In the next step, we keep it as a private site and choose the language. And now I'm going to add some members. Now the site is ready. Next, we go to the site contents, scroll down, and make sure you're in classic SharePoint mode. Now you will see something called Add an App. You will see tasks, and now we can create the task list. You will see this getting created here. Click on the list, and now we can understand how tasks are added. On the top, it shows your timeline, and below, it shows you an empty task list. When I click on New Task, a separate form-like thing appears. Task name, design, today's date, and let's say this is going to finish in 4 days. You add the email ID, assistant, and now I can have more things here like percent completion. Then I go to description, predecessors, and so on. I want to see the start date as well, and maybe some other column. So you will see sort of a ribbon here. So click on list tab and then go to list settings. Scroll down to see that there are multiple views. So when you highlight or hover on all tasks, I get to see how this view displays the data from the list. The selected columns are visible. Select the columns to add to the view. Another important thing here is the order in which the columns will appear. So the column number for due date is 3. So I want start date to be at number 3. Once you have customized everything, then you can click OK. Go to list settings, advanced settings. It is a very important thing to enable a notification whenever you assign a task to someone, and only then will people be notified. Here, you can have attachments for every task as well. I can add the task one by one, or I can click on the edit button, in which case it goes sort of a grid view. I'm going to add a few more items just to have some data here. While you're adding tasks, you can click on the three dots or ellipses and say add or remove to timeline. This way, multiple tasks can be seen at a glance on the timeline. So now I have a task list with assignments. Currently, we are in the All Tasks view. Calendar view changes this same data as a calendar, and you can see what's happening. You can change the view from this drop-down as well. And here we have another view called Gantt chart. And this is what many people want. So if you wanted a Gantt chart quickly in the context of Microsoft platform without buying any new extra product, this is the way to do it. Now let's see how to link the tasks. I want to say that this task called development cannot happen unless design is finished. So design is the predecessor for develop. So I come to the predecessors column, open the dropdown, and say predecessor is designed. I'll have to press tab to save it. You see what happened? There is a link between the two. So I'm going to create such links between test and develop and deploy. So that is how you get a Gantt chart. Now, this is still not perfect because suppose I say that this task, which is supposed to be due on 11. Now, what if I change that this task is going to get delayed or is going to take longer than expected, what should happen? The task which is dependent on it should get delayed, isn't it? But that does not happen. So in true sense of the word project management, this is not a real Gantt chart. In MS Project, this would automatically happen and you'll always get to see the realistic picture based on the links. And that's the whole idea why I'm saying MS Project makes sense even from an ad hoc task management point of view. You will need some kind of analysis to be done. You'll say export to Excel. It'll give you an error, but still it'll download a file called IQI, which Excel does understand how to open. And this gives you the raw data. And then if you want, you can create a pivot table or chart based on this. So from that point of view, analytics is also possible. This task list is based on older version of SharePoint. So it does not integrate with to-do app. I will not see anything in assigned to me. I've added three more tasks, and these are actually under deployment. So they are subtasks. How do you add a subtask? You first add a task and then convert it to a subtask. When you're working on a list like this, you'll see two checkboxes. The first column is for selecting the current row, and this one is the task completion. This is task complete, so it'll be written with this formatting. We don't want to do that. I just want to select these three tasks, and then from the task ribbon, I can say indent, and then they become subtasks. That is how you add subtasks. Another limitation here is these three tasks have their own start and end date. So the start and end date for the main task should get automatically calculated. That does not happen here. And of course, that will happen in Microsoft Project. That's it for SharePoint task list. Soon I'm coming up with a video on MS Project. So till then, have a look at the task management best practices video. So that's it for now. Thank you.